relationship?
Good.
The video.
There's a lot of stuff to think about.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm talking about. You know, I've reworked the whole role in my head, and I know you said that you've been thinking about it, too.
Well, yeah.
So what have you come up with?
Well, the song Nothing Can Stand in the Way of Love is about love. And it's not about sex, not like these cheap, cheesy videos that they have out there.
I know, but unfortunately that's what sells.
Well, that's what they think.
Well, who's they?
Nobody, just the public. You know, the public. Doesn't matter. I can't do it the way that they want to do it. I have to do it my
way. Well, then they're just going to have to trust your vision. I know I do. Just tell me how you want me to be, and I'll be. Okay? Dennis?
Hey.
I forgot to ask, how am I supposed to dress for this date?
Date? Don't say it like that. This is a real date.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, sorry, but it strikes me as funny somehow.
Okay, fine. If you want to get all dialed up, then maybe I'll take you to Antoine's.
How are their enchiladas?
Enchiladas.
See, I have this intense craving for green chili peppers.
Maybe we better go casual then.
Okay.
Okay.
So I will see you in an hour.
Half an hour.
Take a lot of courage for you to come back here. Now that Jamie knows the whole truth, how does he feel about it?
He hates me, and it's over between us. Are you happy? You think I'm lying to you?
I asked you if there was anything else that I should know about you, and granted, I'm giving you a chance to tell me.
And you said there wasn't, because there isn't.
Vicky, is it or isn't it true that my brother kissed you and that you deliberately kept that fact from me?
Okay, that's true. Grant kissed me. I didn't tell you about it.
No, we're not going to talk about any of that stuff tonight, okay? I think we can save all that kind of stuff for the studio. Look, I brought all this nice stuff down. We're going to have a very romantic evening. We're just not going to ruin it with work talk, okay?
You're right. This is so much nicer than VC's spring dancing.
You are so special, Jenna, and nobody knows that better than you. Nobody.
Is anyone there?
Me? Man.
I'm really sorry to bother you, but duty calls.
Matt, there's no telephones down here, man. You know, maybe that's why we come here in the first place.
That's why I had to make the trip down, Dean.
Well, what could be so important that you have to interrupt our evening? I mean, we hardly get any time alone as it is.
It's okay, Ron. I'll just be right over there and you guys can talk.
Where?
I'll be right there, okay?
Well, don't.
I won't.
Don't come too far.
I'll be careful.
Matt, you
trying to mess us up again like you used to now that you don't have Lauren?
It's about Dean. I know things are bad. They're about to get worse.
Really?
Now, did you tell Jenna that Ace wants to replace her with Mara in the new video?
No, I didn't, Matt. No, because I haven't even decided whether I'm going to take their suggestion.
It's not a suggestion. It's an ultimatum.
Matt, let me ask you something. What if I decide that I don't want to take their ultimatum? I want to give my own ultimatum. How's that?
Now you'll probably end up sweeping floors at Sassy's again. They're not fooling around. If you don't toe the line, they have no problem pulling their money from the new video.
I don't think they're going to do that,
dude. You really want to take that chance? Jackson came back after you left. He told us Mara's on her way to Bay City. She's expecting you at her hotel room.
Well, you can tell Jackson, Mr. Ultimatum Jackson, I'm not going to be at her hotel, okay?
I'm not telling him anything. From here on out, you do what you want.
Damn straight, I will.
That's great, Dean. That's wonderful. Whatever happens, I got a future. If you're not worried about your own, maybe think about Janice.
What do you think I've been doing, Matt?
Well, think about how she'll feel if you do blow off Ace and she finds out she was the reason. She'll never forgive herself. Or you.
Dean! Dean, look! I found a flower that only blooms at night. Isn't it beautiful? John Hudson, I haven't seen you in a boat!
Oh, it's good to see you, Ada. Well, Gregory and I don't hunker down for the winter. I thought I needed a night out.
Well, you picked a good night for it. The place is jumping.
Donna is not with her latest wallet.
Oh, you mean the operator?
Yeah, Roger Jackson, CEO of Ace Holdings.
Well, she's better off smoothing the senator.
Maybe I'll just walk out there and see what's going on.
Don't you dare.
What?
Ryan and Victoria have a problem. They can solve it themselves.
Oh, yes? What?
You know perfectly well, if you go out there and get in the middle of that, you turn it to your advantage.
Why, Donna, do you think I've been?
I think you're a genius.
Of course I am. I'm a politician.
Well, this isn't the caucus. This is my daughter's happiness, and I won't have you tampering with it.
You know, Donna, this mama bear concern of yours is very touching. Perhaps you should consider this. Maybe you and Vicky are holding on to a fantasy. Indeed, if Ryan is not the right man for her after all.
Well, Harrison, I don't care how big or how important you are, I don't see how you look at yourself anymore.
I don't really see why you're making such a big deal about it. I mean, it was just a little kiss.
It was completely inconsequential. It was a non-event.
Since when is a kiss a non-event?
Okay, I really think I see what's happening here. You know, we're seeing things from different perspectives. Private eye, you know, of a policeman. It's not really a very kissy business, but politics is like show business. You know, it's kissy. People are kissing all the time.
Vicky, politicians kiss babies. They don't kiss their assistants.
Well, that's about the impact it had. To tell you the truth, you're trying to make it into some huge affair or something.
Vicky, you're still covering.
Covering what?
Okay. All right, let's just stop. We'll just go back. Tell me how and why it happened,
and also when.
I think I know where this is coming from.
Good.
Paulina.
You're evading the question again.
Do you deny she's the one who told you? I mean, certainly Grant didn't tell you, and the only other person I told was my mother.
Oh, so you can tell Donna about an inconsequential kiss, and you can taunt Paulina with it, but you certainly can't tell me.
No, I couldn't tell you because I knew you would react exactly the way you're reacting. You'd be hurt, and you'd be mad, and you'd accuse me of cheating on you.
You still don't even think that you did anything wrong.
Could you just, you know, stop being a policeman for 1 minute? I think you ruined what could have been a really wonderful evening planning our wedding by turning a little something into a big something. I mean, Grant was just being Grant.
You really just don't get this, do you?
What?
Vicky, it has nothing to do with a kiss. It has nothing to do with Grant. It has everything to do with honesty. And I don't think that we can survive without it. And I don't even think you know what it is.
Well, I mean, it's finished between Jimmy and me. You finally got what you wanted.
Wait. You listen to me. Before you start accusing me of everything, you were the one that sat next to my bed with those big, serious eyes, asking me those deep, soul-searching questions, like whether I was ready to give up my lifestyle and become a father, Marley.
Those questions were real.
Yeah, I know they were. I've been thinking about them ever since. But what I didn't know is that what you really wanted was that baby for yourself.
Okay, fine. I have to go through a big recitation of all my sins. I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I'm guilty.
To tell you the truth, I don't even know what it is I'm so guilty of anymore.
Why don't you try lying, for starters?
I am not the only one who manipulated the truth for their own purposes.
Yeah, well, Olivia is paying her dues right now.
I'm not talking about Olivia.
You mean me? The only thing that I've wanted since this whole thing exploded was to do right by everybody, that's all.
Lying to Olivia, leading her on, making her think you want this child? That's the right thing to do?
What? Are you telling me that you think that that I'm seeing Olivia as some sort of a ploy to stop her from giving you the baby?
I'm just saying it's over, all right? You accomplished what you set out to do. Your best friend is no longer going to marry the wrong woman.
Sorry, Marley. I never meant for you to get hurt.
You never wanted Jamie and Jamie together. I mean, not even after you sort of started to like me.
Marley, it wasn't my business.
I know, but I mean, I could feel it.
Marley, I don't even understand any of this anymore.
I don't either. I mean, seemed so simple, and then all of a sudden it got so complicated. I wanted a child that I couldn't have, and Olivia was having a child she didn't want. I mean, it just seemed like some sort of a gift.
Molly, there's still a baby coming, and it needs to be loved and to be cared for.
I could have done that. I guess it's kind of beside the point.
Well, don't make this any harder than it already is.
It cost me, Jamie, Dennis. But I was willing to... I am willing to pay the price for that because I really believe that I could be a good mother for your child.
Are you saying that after all of this, You're willing to raise this child without Jamie?
Yes. Oh, God, yes. Jamie, you're supposed to be Dennis's best friend. We can't allow him to ruin his life like this.
Iris, I don't want to talk about it. Please, just go away.
Oh, can't you listen? I will not allow Dennis to be driven to marrying Olivia. She's totally wrong for him. Well, she's hardly more than a child herself, and she's so sneaky and opportunistic. Look what a mess she's made.
She didn't make it alone.
Goodness, they only slept together once.
That's all it takes.
Sometimes. Anyway, who's to know if Dennis really is the father? She's lied about everything else. But Marley doesn't seem to care who the father is anyway.
Oh, that's very clear.
She's so desperate to have this baby, and she would make a glorious mother. Offering Marley the baby was the one intelligent thing Olivia has done.
Iris, you may be chairman of the board of this hospital, but if you don't get out of this doctor's lounge in the next 5 seconds, I'm calling security.
Thank you, Jamie.
Hi, Iris.
I need to talk to you.
Oh, how's it going? Last time we spoke.
Professionally, doctor. Did you change the meds on Mr. Arkin, room 571?
Yes, I did. The blood test.
There is no authorization on this chart.
Well, I know.
You are not allowed to change medications without the name and countersignature on the chart. Now, I'm the one in charge of this case, and I was not consulted.
You weren't there. The liver function not bad. There wasn't any code blue room 1011.
Okay. We'll settle this later. You don't even bother to tell me that you dropped by Grant's to go do some work, and you pretended that you were at home. Twice you did that. Whenever I bring up Grant's name, you evade it. Now I find out that he kissed you, and you think that it's an inconsequential point.
Who's covering now? Well, I mean, I think the whole issue is really pretty simple here.
Oh, it is.
You're jealous.
Of course I'm jealous. I never denied that.
You should understand Grant more. You'd realize that there is no reason to be.
Oh, so now you understand Grant a whole hell of a lot more than you understand me.
Maybe it's because you're more complicated. You know, I mean, Grant has an ego the size of this whole stage.
So is that why you let him kiss you?
I was trying to prove a point.
Excuse me?
I was worried about him and Pauline. I mean, I really believed that she could ruin his career. I was just trying to show him that he could possibly be attracted to other women.
To you.
I just happened to be there. All right, look, I'm sorry. I know. I was playing with fire, and I got burned. I kissed. We kissed. It was stupid. I know. I was just trying to make a point, though. That's all.
I really don't believe that I'm hearing this.
Stupid. You know, I was trying to teach him a lesson, but what happened is he ended up teaching me a lesson. I was truly mortified by the whole thing, and actually he was somewhat amused. It's not a reason to end it with your whole family or to let it ruin things with us.
The worst thing is that you can't even be honest with yourself.
Honesty is not the bottom line. I mean, it's something to strive for, but...
Vicky, honesty is basic.
To you. I think this is what's going on here. I mean, you know, it's like we inherited our parents' honesty genes. Marley certainly inherited Dad's, right? Up until recently, but still, you know what I mean? She's true blue, and I, without a doubt, inherited my mother's. And then it's like Grant inherited Spencer's. Can we just go inside? Just go inside and plan our wedding? I promise you that nothing like this is ever going to happen.
I don't think that I can go back inside and make nice with Grant and with Donna. No, not after all this.
Okay, come on. It's over between Paulina and me. We're even, right? Why do you have to continue on with this?
Because I can't live like this. Don't you understand? I have been betrayed by my brother and my father my whole life. I can't live thinking that you're lying to me or that you're protecting or that you're even lying to yourself.
So, we're gonna break up over this? I mean, after everything we've been through?
Okay, I don't know what's happening right now. I don't know you. I certainly don't know us anymore. But what I do know is that it can't go on like this.
Ryan!
They say, tie a knot and hang on to
it. I need something to hang on to. I guess that's why I was so just surprised when you said you wanted to take responsibility. I mean, I thought, why now?
Because it really sums up about how you feel about me.
No. I meant what I said in the hospital, Dennis. You've really, you've come to mean a great deal to me. That's why it hurt me so much when you didn't think I was good enough for Jamie.
Well, I never said or meant anything like that.
Well, Jamie has, so I guess it's kind of a split point.
In terms of the baby.
If you and Olivia should decide that you don't want to raise this child, I would. I still want to. I mean, with all my heart.
As a single parent.
Any way you say, any conditions you set up, anything. I just wanted a child to love. I mean, I never wanted it as some kind of a bait to get Jamie back.
Oh, I never thought that about you, Marley.
I don't know. I mean, maybe I did act on some kind of impulse when Olivia first came to me, but I just really believed that if I didn't say yes right then and there, that her second choice, it was an abortion. Not Sam. I know that that is her right, but I just couldn't bear it.
I just couldn't bear it, not the way I wanted a child for so long.
With or without Jamie?
All of this turmoil has really made me realize, Dennis, that I could raise a child on my own. Maybe even someday with another man. I don't know if you're one of us.
Right, that'll happen. Someday, if you want it.
It's hard to give up a dream, you know, of having a family with Jamie. Who knows?
Marley, suppose Jamie were willing to forgive you for all this and try again.
Oh, that would be... that would be beyond anything.
In other words, you still love him.
Of course I do.
Let me ask you this question, Marley. Do you love him enough to give up this baby to get him back?
So you never stop worrying about them, even when they're all grown up.
I just find it hard to believe that a woman who looks like you could have grown-up daughters.
Oh, thank you. You just made my day.
Have you no dignity?
Excuse me. This is my brother-in-law, Dr. John Hudson. This is Roger Jackson.
Doctor, nice to meet you.
Would you excuse us for just a minute? I haven't seen him in ages.
By all means.
I'll talk to you later. Don't start with me. I was just trying to find a little solace with some charming company.
Don't forget Rich.
I never forget Rich.
This is phase one of the master plan?
Well, I need some kind of distraction. Mm-hmm. Both of my daughters are emotional wrecks, and I don't know how to handle it.
Why? What's wrong with you?
Well, Victoria's having terrible problems with Ryan and Marley. Who knows about Marley? She's got that wall up again.
It worked, you know.
Worry, I'm trying to go after Roger Jackson. Not yet, anyway. I've got to save all my energies on my children.
We're not talking about that. I mean, you can't manipulate your daughter's happiness.
But at least I can try to guide them in the right direction.
The right direction? Donald, what makes you think you know what the right direction is?
Well, you giant corporation types sure do come equipped, don't you?
Oh, it's simply a letter of intent to sell Paradise to the Ace Restaurant Group at a future date. At a price to be mutually agreed upon, of course.
I can read. Thank you.
I want you to think of this as a headache prescription and a ticket to spend more time with your grandchildren.
Also great-grandchildren.
No.
Oh, give me a break. I got married young. That is your trump card, though.
Yes, free time, fewer hassles. Some peace of mind.
How do you figure?
Well, you'll be able to draw on the resources of Ace Holding if you ever need to.
I can draw on the resources of Corey Publishing if I ever need to. But I never have. And I am my own boss.
Like I said, you still would be. At Ace, we go by the slogan, if it works, don't fix it.
If it ain't broke. It's a good slogan. It makes sense.
Look, Ada, if we didn't like the way you ran this place, we wouldn't be interested.
Oh, I do get tired of trying to make Paradise live up to its name, though.
Yeah, maybe we could change it to Pretty Fair or Not Half Bad, huh?
You're a little ahead of yourself, Roger. I'm a long way from thinking of this as a we.
Take your time. Take all the time you need. But meanwhile, so help keep the sharks out of our waters.
Other sharks, you mean, right?
Vicky, are you all right? Parking lot attendant said I might find you out here. Should I be minding my own business?
No, it's all right. It's gone. A big fight. Maybe the last.
Let me guess, was it about the role of the family in your wedding?
No. It was about something a lot bigger than that.
I can leave you alone, right? Listen. sorry that things seemed to fall apart so quickly after you got back. You seemed all poised to give it the Vicky Hudson try.
Where's the kiss? Where's that when you kissed me?
What's the problem?
I didn't tell him. He's kind of big on honesty.
I'm sorry you're hurting. Would you like me to take you someplace? You did a fine job insisting on that drink just now.
Thank you. Excuse me, I have something in my eye.
Want me to take a look?
No, I got it. Look, Dr. Frame, I didn't get a chance to tell you, but I had gotten authorization for the med change from Dr. Hudson.
You didn't have him sign the chart, Kelsey.
I didn't have time.
There are no excuses in this hospital, okay?
Well, then maybe I'm not going to fit in here after all. I'm human, Dr. Frame, and therefore flawed, and obviously you're not.
Wait a minute.
I'm not finished with you, Doctor.
I mean, how can you even ask me a question like that? You know how I feel about Jamie. What we had was wonderful, and it was true, and I can't believe I've destroyed
Marley, it. Marley, please.
What, so you don't think we have a chance to get back together again?
It's not my place to say, Marley. I'd be taking a guess.
But you know him probably better than anyone, and you know me after all these months, and look, I'm not a quitter, Dennis.
I know that, Marley. I'm just saying, check out some of your other options.
I have. I can raise this child by myself if I have to.
Maybe you won't have to.
I can't just turn off the way I feel about Jamie. Just the way I can't turn off wanting to have this child.
I hear you, Marley. That's great. That's great, okay? I wish you the best of luck in whatever you decide to do, okay? I gotta go. I gotta talk to Olivia. I gotta go pick her up.
I'm flying out with Olivia.
Yes.
Yes.
I'll close it. Dennis, I just...
You just what? You want to ask me what we're going to decide about the baby? I don't know yet, Marley, okay? I don't know.
No,
we have a lot to talk about.
I just wanted to know if you could ever forgive me for all the lying and everything.
Like I said, Marley, this is all going to take some time.
Dennis has already left.
I know that. I waited till he left. We didn't finish our conversation, the one we started Sam and Anders.
I am tired, okay? It's okay.
I'll do the talking. And you can listen until I'm through.
I can't believe last summer when you and I were swimming in Felicia and Lucas and Matt found us.
No, 4th of July. 4th of July. We sent some fireworks off ourselves. Thank you.
Us then and us now. Wow. So much has changed. I mean, you're a big star and you've got such an incredible future.
You're a big star. It's not what's important. It's how I feel about you.
Stop it. I had this dream way before I came into the picture.
Well, things change.
Well, they shouldn't. Not with your talent and your music. Something that you should share with the whole world.
We're both tired, don't you think? Maybe just call it a night, okay?
All right, well, just know one thing, okay? I love you more every moment, every night. There's no answer. Victoria's and Ryan's cars.
Well, maybe they're out someplace working it all out.
Well, I hope it's someplace romantic.
I just wanted to say goodnight.
Oh, so early?
Yes, I'm afraid there's some business I have to attend to. May I call you tomorrow?
If you don't call me, I'll call.
All right.
Goodnight.
Night.
Oh, stop looking so gloomy.
A word of advice.
Another one.
You're still at loose ends about Michael. You should wait at least a year before you get into another relationship.
Says who?
One who knows.
I gotta go.
I don't know about you, I could eat Mexican food 5 nights a week.
Yeah, well, I like a tamale every so often, but I'm more into the French cuisine kind of thing. It's not like a snobby kind of thing. I spent a lot of time over there, you know.
Did you ever catch the Paris Ballet when you were there?
No, actually.
Hey, you know, there's an open rehearsal tomorrow morning of the Chicago Company's Midsummer Night's Dream. Would you like to go with me?
I would like to go, but I've got to try out one of my new replacement cars tomorrow on the track. So another time, maybe?
Okay. It's not good. Where could he go?
Probably off
sulking somewhere.
Don't!
I'm sorry. I don't mean to badmouth my own brother. It's just... we all know how moody he can get. Just give him some time to digest it.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, I had to get this off my chest. I never meant to become an issue between you and Ryan.
I know that.
Okay, but we both know it was wise of you to keep this kiss between us.
Right, what if it didn't have a backfire?
It's just that I think it's very interesting. Ryan demands honesty, and yet when he encounters the truth, how does he behave?
Grant,
please, let me finish. I started this. I'd like to finish it. I'm not real fond of the way he treats you. He doesn't accept. He doesn't look at you for what you really are.
You certainly don't understand everything about our relationship.
I know what I see, and I know that you deserve a hell of a lot better.
No. You see, Ryan brings out the best in me. It just doesn't have to be enough right now.
Ryan's expectations aren't reasonable. His notion of honesty is naive. Nobody measures up to Ryan's standards.
You always said I could do everything I ever said I could do.
Doesn't this tire you? Don't you just love to relax and be who you are and be loved for that?
Ryan loves me, Grant. And I love him.
The one who told me that love isn't always enough.
I did?
We were talking about Paulina at the time. You should take that to heart. Consider the alternative.
What is that supposed to mean?
Maybe Ryan is the wrong man for you after all.
Them you'd show. You and I are going to be the hottest team in music video.
How's it going, Mara? How are you?
Come to Mama.
Why don't you tell me what's going on?
I think I made a mistake in judgment.
About a
patient.
No, about myself and my ability to handle this situation.
You'll see. 2 months ago, a doctor named Harrison showed up here, dead sure she was going to come out on top.
Well, she's not so sure anymore.
You have the brains, the talent, and the dedication. You were fine until you overextended yourself and got sick.
Hey, you warned me. I didn't listen.
And doctors fresh out of med school tend to think they're invincible. Learning that is part of your training.
Well, I guess I got that part right then.
So you're going to let this just knock you out of the running, huh? You're doing well here. If you need more time to work on your project...
No! Okay? No, I don't want any special favors. No special treatment. I mean, it's not worth it when you do it like that.
Why is it so hard for you to take help?
Would you give it to the others?
Of course I would, to anyone who showed me that they were working hard.
Yeah, well, I don't think the other interns would have allowed themselves to behave like that.
Well, maybe they're not as honest as you are. Stick with me, Kelsey. I'll see you get what you need to make it.
This is fun, but where is it going?
That was the whole point, to find out where it is.
Well, so far we found out that you like French food and I like Mexican food. You are bored to death.
I didn't say
and
that.
And I think racing cars is some strange form of insanity.
Oh, you do, huh? Well, let me ask you this. Did you think it was insane before I had my little spin out in the Bay Area 250?
Well, it certainly didn't help. I can't believe that you're still racing. Are you afraid?
Finding out that I was going to be a father made me more afraid than any racetrack I've ever been on. Anyway, what's the story with this guy, David?
Well, he's away right now at a physical therapy conference, but when he gets back and winds up that I lied to him, too, I'm sure whatever we were starting to have is going to be over.
So how do you feel about that?
Sad. I never meant to hurt David. I think he might have been in love with me.
But it wasn't mutual. So there you go. There's something in common right there. We don't love one another.
Excuse me?
Olivia, it's like this, okay? You take two people. They're not in love, but they like each other very much. They have a lot of differences, but hey, that makes it interesting. It gives them somewhere to go. But they do share one thing that makes them want to stay together. They created a life together.
Oh, Dennis, you can't possibly be suggesting what I think you're suggesting.
Marley, I'm not leaving. Well, you can stay here alone tonight because I'm not going to stay here and listen to you go on and on and on about Dennis and Olivia.
I really do admire your honesty. Well, I assure you, you are about the only person who does. I truly believe that you deserve that baby that you so desperately want. Don't you dare do this to me. But I want you to... You want me to help you manipulate your son. I won't do it. You don't understand. No, I understand that you don't want Dennis with Olivia.
Yes, but it's not because I dislike Olivia. It's because I don't want my son to ruin his life over some foolish idea of morality. Besides, he doesn't love Olivia.
Oh, well, then that's just fine, because you know something? Dennis doesn't believe in love.
You're wrong, Marley. He's in love with somebody else.
Oh, yeah?
Who's that? It's you, Marley. Dennis is in love with you.
Good night, Fred. You've said too much and you've stayed too long.
I think you deserve a dose of...
I mean it!
Here. What are the odds on a marriage when a man can't trust his wife and she thinks she's not good enough for him?
I've said too much tonight, all right?
Oh, so you can be honest with me and not my brother because we understand each other.
Married people have a whole lifetime to learn how to understand each other.
But if they click together to begin with, then they don't have to. Why are you fighting this, Vicky?
Because clicking isn't love.
We work well together. We function socially. Practically read each other's minds because we're on the same wavelength.
All right, look, you are way out of line here, and you are just taking advantage of this situation.
Because I want to. I won't stand by and watch. what you cling to Ryan's high ideal is what is killing you. They're full of shoulds and ought-tos and high moral fiber that's impossible to digest.
Ryan changed my life.
Mine too, the day he sent you to me.
We didn't.